So it's day six, and I'm gonna play some Chaconne. But first, I would like to show you my practice buddy that just joined me. So I hope you can see me from over there. I don't want to disturb him, but I really wanted to capture that on camera because I thought it was really cute. So anyway, here's some Chaconne. I have so far, for now, decided to stick with starting up bow. And I'm also forming this interpretation in my mind that has yet to be something that I've heard performed by anyone yet, which can sometimes be a good thing. It can also sometimes be a bad thing. So, what I'm imagining is a very slow, not slow, soft, like meditative first 4 bars. And then the second statement of the chords are louder. So it's like a reverse echo. It starts soft and then gets louder and more bold the second time instead of the opposite. So today I'm going to try to get that to come across and see if it sounds weird. And maybe that's why everybody just starts the chaconne all big and boomy and here we go. But I'm gonna try to start it chill and see if it works. So today we'll be focusing mostly on dynamics. little chunk today. I printed out a version. This is something that's it's a different version than the book that I was using, which is the, if I've got it here, the Galamian version. I also have, I believe it's the Joachim book with the or a text directly underneath. This one has the facsimile in the back. I wanted a version that was pretty much devoid of bowings, mostly because the Galamian has a ton of bowings and fingerings in it, and fingerings can sometimes be helpful, but both of my professors have been believers in playing as much of Bach in first position as possible instead of going up in positions and doing fancy things, that a lot of the Romantic or early 1900s players did. They romanticized Bach. And we're, some of us in this generation are trying to go back to a little bit more of Baroque performance style, which they wouldn't probably have used so many upper positions. They would have stayed down in first position more often and tried to get the tone and color change from the bow instead of from going just higher on a different string. So that's what I'm trying to achieve here, is staying mostly in first position. First or second. I mean, of course, third position is required here and there, but like avoiding fourth, fifth, all of those things up there, avoiding harmonics. You can tell that I didn't really work out a fingering just yet for that last little section that I played. Yeah, I. Whatever. I just added that today, and I was playing it out of the Galamian book, which had some fingerings and, you know, things to navigate your way back down from third position. I don't have that in this version. I also am going to do a sort of music theory analysis of it, but right now, what I'm doing is, it probably won't get picked up on camera. I'm making a pencil mark where I think the cadences are, where I think the actual end of a section cadences are, because there's one, if you have bar numbers in your part, there is kind of a D minor cadence on beat 2 of measure 42, but that cadence is immediately navigated away from, and the actual next cadence doesn't hit until the downbeat of 49. So it sounded like a cadence, but then it immediately went on and started doing a whole bunch of noodly stuff. So I did an awesome, really helpful mini analysis of the fugue once, where I just traced the fugue subject in blue pen so that I could keep track of where my fugue subject, which voice it was in at all times. Yeah, anyway, I'm now just rambling, but I already did the playing bit, so if you're still here, you're apparently interested in hearing what I have to say. I'm gonna head to work now. Baron left me for the heater. I started getting a little too, I was moving around too much for him. So now he's down here in front of the heating vent. But he is my practice buddy. He's my number one fan, and he always hangs out when I practice. Except for when I was playing Stravinsky earlier today. And then he stayed away for a little while, but then joined me on. I was sitting on my bed practicing, and he laid down right behind me. He's a super fan. Anyway, I am going to go to work now, so I will see you tomorrow with maybe the same amount of chaconne, but with some actual fingering planning included, and maybe some more bowing planning included. Anyway, see you tomorrow on day 7.